In this video, I'm going to be explaining you about the disadvantages and advantages of different crank angle. In the previous video, which I told the difference about all the different crank angles, and one guy commented that he wants to know the advantages and disadvantages of all the different crank angles. So I'm making this video for you, brother. So let's get started with the video. So the first type I am going to be talking about is the 180 degree crank angle, and in this type there is one popular bike in Indian market or in the international market as well, which is known as the Yamaha R3. And in Yamaha R3, the crank angle is 180 degree. So when the one piston is moving upwards and the other piston will be moving downwards. So due to this, the advantages and disadvantages of this type of crank angle is, there are, number one, the advantage is there will be a smoother delivery of power. So when the pistons are moving up and down, there is no lag in the power, such as the bottom end will be as same as the mid range and the top end. So the bottom end torque will be high, and the mid range will be high, and also the top end will be high. There is no power loss in this type of crank angle engine twin cylinders. So that's the main advantages of this type of crank angles. The other advantages is, because it has a very good bottom end, the fuel efficiency will be very high. Since the bottom end torque is so high, you can sweep through the cities in the taller gears as well. Even if you are running in this bike on the third or fourth gear in the city, there is no problem. It will be able to pull the bike easily, and not such a case of the 360 degree crank angle. So and everything has a disadvantage, and in this type of engines, the disadvantage is the top end, I should say, because the top end will be, the RPM will end at 11,500 or 12,000 RPM, such as the Yamaha R3, which has an red line limit of 12K RPM. So that's the only disadvantage. Also, the 12K RPM is very high, but 12K RPM is the maximum that can a twin cylinder 180 degree crank angle can go. Which I'm going to be talking about is the 360 degree or the 0 degree crank angle. So this is a bit of a controversial or bit of a one guy pick, because this engine can be found in so many variants of Kawasaki's, such as the Ninja 300, Ninja 650. So I'm going to be taking Ninja 300 because that's the most affordable Kawasaki which is available in India, and one of the most affordable twin cylinder as well. So 360 degree crank angle is same as 0 degree crank angle, and it acts as a big one cylinder engine, because both the cylinders will be moving upwards and downwards together. There is no separate crank angle, such as there is no separate movement, such as the R3, which will be moving in different direction. So both the pistons will be moving upward and downwards at the same time. So because of this, the advantages are, you are gonna get an unlimited top end. Man, the Ninja 300 revs until 13,500 RPM. So if you consider that, it is very, very, very high for a 300cc. Honestly, 13,500 RPM is too high, I should say, but people love the top end scream of Ninja 300. So this is one of the advantage, and one more advantage is, because it has such an amazing top end, the top speed will increase. So horsepower is equal to or directly proportional to RPM. So because of this, the top end will increase. So even if you have a similar bike with the same power but a different RPM or a lower RPM, the Ninja 300 will have a higher top speed because it has a high RPM. So this is one of the major advantages with the Ninja 300. But the one of the most or two of the most disgusting thing or the things which I don't like about this engine is the bottom end is nothing. So you have to keep revving the engine to get that power or to get that feel of 300 cc power. So there is nothing until the 5000 rpm in this type of engines. So bottom end is very low. Instead of in the R3, when you can ride it in third or fourth gear, Ninja 300 will demand second or first gear. So that's the most advantage disadvantage of this type of engine. And the other disadvantage is because you will be revving the engine in the top end, so the fuel efficiency will also decrease. So when you are in the high rev range, when you have, when because you are ringing the throttle every time, the efficiency will definitely decrease. So the R3 can give much more fuel efficiency and much more usable power in the low end and the top end and the mid range. In the Ninja 300, you are gonna get a low fuel efficiency since you have to keep on ringing the throttle. The third type is the 270 degree crank angle. Now I should say this is the best of the both worlds. Either a 180 degree or a 270 degree is the best thing that you can afford or you can choose, because the 270 degree crank angle is a mixture of a V-twin and a parallel twin. So parallel twin as such, the inline twin like the R3, and 90 degree V-twin such as the Harleys which are using the 90 degree V-twin. So this the combination of these two engines is what a 270 degree crank angle will be produced. So the advantage of this crank angle engines are the bottom end and mid range is very strong. So because it has a 270 degree crank angle, there is no still in the piston movement. Even if you use the other two engines, the 360 degree and 180 degree, at one moment both the pistons will stop moving, which is not a case in 270 degree crank angle. So whenever you ring the throttle, the pistons will be moving, so the bottom end and the mid range is very strong. Now where this engine lacks is the top end. These type of engines will not have an amazing top end, not even like the R3, and you should never consider to be going for a top end race with these type of engines. Now 270 degree crank angle engine in India is, or even in the international market, is the Interceptor 650 and Continental GT 650 from the Royal Enfield. And the another most loved 270 degree crank angle twin cylinder is the Honda's Africa Twin. So these are the most differentiating things about these crank angles. So the disadvantage of 270 degree crank angle is, as I explained, the top end is pretty low, and the advantages are amazing pickup at the lower range and the mid range. You never need a first gear or the second gear in the cities. You can pretty much go on in the third gear from as low as 20 degree, 20 kilometers per hour, and until the top speed, whatever it can achieve in the third or fourth gear. So because of this, the fuel efficiency also increases, and because you need not change the gear every time, and because it has in such an amazing low end and mid range, you never need to keep ringing the throttle like the Ninja 300 or the 360 degree crank angle engines. So that's it for this video, guys. Hope you boys have enjoyed this video and gained some of the knowledge which I have, and whatever I know, I have shared with you. So if you find it useful, make sure you like the video. Even if you don't like the video, make sure you comment down what you didn't like about the video so that I can improve on it. And even if you like or don't like, please subscribe to my channel and stay home and stay safe.